Beloved, we are learning the power of a covenant relationship with God and the frustrations the spirit of right engineers into a covenant relationship. I welcome you with that thought to this Wednesday edition of the Voice of Resurrection Devotional. Beloved, since we understand the power of God's covenant relationship with us, that we know that our responsibility is to walk in humility and get out of strife with others so that what God intended will manifest. No matter who you are, somebody will do you wrong. Somebody will take advantage. Somebody will be ungrateful or treat you in such a manner that you will vow never to do things for anybody. But the devil is a liar. I decree that you are overcoming that hurt in Jesus' name. You are overcoming that disappointment in Jesus' name. You are overcoming that betrayal in the name of Jesus. And I take authority over every demonic force oppressing you with the memory of your negative experiences, that they will release their grip off of you in the name of Jesus. Today is a new day. Today is a breakthrough day. Today is a day of favor in Jesus' name. Amen. All right, let's go to the Word of God before our time runs out. In Exodus 17, verse 8, the Bible says, "Then came Amalek and fought with Israel in Rephidim. And Moses said unto Joshua, choose us out men and go out, fight with Amalek. Tomorrow I will stand on the top of the hill with the rod of God in mine hand." So Joshua did as Moses had said to him and fought with Amalek. And Moses, Aaron, and Hur went up to the top of the hill. And it came to pass when Moses held up his hand that Israel prevailed. And when he let down his hand, Amalek prevailed. Oh, beloved, you got to get the mystery. Hallelujah. But Moses' hands were heavy, and they took a stone and put it under him, and he sat thereon. And Aaron and Hur stayed up his hands, the one on the one side and the other on the other side, and his hands were steady until the going down of the sun. And Joshua discomfited Amalek and his people with the edge of the sword. And the Lord said unto Moses, write this for a memorial in a book, and rehearse it in the ears of Joshua. For I will utterly put out the remembrance of Amalek from under heaven. And Moses built an altar and called the name of it Jehovah Nissi. For he said, because the Lord has sworn that the Lord will have war with Amalek from generation to generation. Wow. Beloved, this story is replete or filled with revelation and power. Listen carefully. All through the history of the nation of Israel, in their deliverance from Egypt and all the future conquests over the enemy, you will see that God will step forward and fight the battle for Israel, as he did in Jericho, as he eventually did in Ai, as he did in all the other major conflicts. He did that through Gideon. He did that through Samson. He did that in so many ways through the Bible. You see, when one angel killed 185,000 Assyrian soldiers in one night. Beloved, so much glory, so much power. But yet, when it came to Amalek, the sons of Esau, when it came to this battle in Rephidim, because God had a covenant with the people, just as he had a covenant with Israel, the battle did not go like that. I don't know any better scripture to illustrate what is happening to all of us in church today. We are two people that are born again and spirit-filled and have a covenant with the Lord through Jesus Christ, whether they know it or understand it or not. are engaged in strife or in battles, and the grace of God is frustrated because God has a covenant with both people. It cannot be fought as if it was God on one side and the enemy on the other. It's such a challenging, frustrating thing because Jesus called all of us in John 17 to unity and to oneness so that the world will believe he is the one. I am speaking to you, beloved, this morning. If you're engaged in strife, if you're fighting with people at your church, on your job, on your family, stop it. Stop it. Do not frustrate the grace of God in your life. Beloved, the dynamic of this battle was so different. So Moses received an unction from the Lord to send Joshua down into the battle while he and Aaron and Hur, the priests, will go up the mountain. And the Bible says, as Moses' hand stayed up, Israel will have the victory. The moment his hands went down, Amalek will start winning. Beloved, learn that's how you deal with your brothers and sisters when there are problems. Oh, lift up your hand. Begin to worship the Lord. Begin to lift him up. Begin to praise him. Begin to declare his majesty, his glory, his grace. Because as soon as your hand or your worship starts going down, the enemy will win. Amalek will win. You have to learn to keep worshiping. Learn to keep celebrating. Learn to keep on magnifying the Lord. And I know my time is gone, beloved. I will be back tomorrow to keep dealing deeper, digging deeper in this mystery and believing God that you will get a breakthrough listening to me. We love you. See you tomorrow. God bless you. Bye-bye. The Lord is waiting.